E-cigarette fumes, toxic or not, and for whom?
Yeah, I am concerned, and Dr. Chant and I are very concerned about this issue.
Passive vaping fears bystanders are facing potential health impacts simply by being nearby.
We're not prepared to put people at risk who are simply around those people who are using this product.
Now closely monitoring new data both here and abroad. One US study finding children exposed to secondhand vapor showed higher levels of metabolites, which can lead to diabetes, heart disease and cancer. Another in 2022 found an increased risk of bronchitic symptoms and shortness of breath among young adults.
I think most people would encounter the idea that, oh, they're much less dangerous than cigarettes.
Though England's National Health Service claims the limited evidence available does suggest any risk from passive vaping to bystanders is small relative to cigarettes.
We don't know that. It's far too soon to know.
But with the risk unknown, governments aren't taking any chances. Right now, the laws around vaping are the same as those for smoking cigarettes. It's illegal in all enclosed public spaces and some places outdoors.
But we know there is an impact, and that's why we're taking action.
Their approach, better to be safe than sorry. Amber Laidler, 7 News.